Okay, so we're going to start in section 1.1. We're going to look at an introduction to limits. Limits are a crucial aspect of calculus, and they're the fundamental things that calculus deals with. So when we go on into other sections, we're going to be looking at limits, and we're going to be tying those things in. They're basically sort of the building blocks of all of calculus. Now, the concept of limits we're going to introduce now. And the key thing about limits is that they're not calculating where we are at the moment, but rather what values we are approaching. All right. So limits are not concerned where we are at, but rather what we are approaching. And in mathematics, we're talking about a function's value. So we're saying, what number is a function's output getting close to as the input gets close to some number? So let's take a look at an example here. We have a nice quadratic function. F of x equal to x squared plus 2x minus 1. And we're going to ask, what does the output get closer to as the value x gets closer to 2? So what does the function's output get closer to as x gets closer and closer and closer to 2? Now we're going to have two approaches when we deal with limits in this section. The first method, the first approach, is what we call the numerical method, or finding a limit numerically. So here's how we do that. We're going to look at this function, f of x equals x squared plus 2x minus 1, and we're going to evaluate this numerically. Now, what most of us like to do when we talk about numerical values is insert a couple of tables. And so what we're going to do is we're going to input a table which has some inputs and some outputs. And remember, we want the function to get closer and closer and closer to the number 2. So we can do that from below. Or did I say the function? I apologize. We want the input to get closer and closer and closer and closer to 2. So what we could do here is maybe we start at 1.5 and then go to 1.9. That got closer. 1.99, that got closer to 2. 1.999, that got closer to 2. And you can kind of continue this indefinitely if you want to. So if we have an input of 1.5, well, what we can do is we can plug that into our function f of 1.5, and we can come out with an output value. Now, I'm going to do this fairly quickly, so I'm not going to show each and every step, because I hope that by this point in your mathematical careers, you are able to plug in a number into a function and get out an output. So in this case, when you plug in 1.5, you should get an output of 4.25. All right. So I'm going to erase this part. And we're going to continue to fill in this table. So an input of 1.5 gave me an output of 4.25. What about an input of 1.9? Well, an input of 1.9 gives me an output of 6.41. How about 1.99? That's 6.9401. How about 1.999? Well, that's 6.994001. What if I want one more? 1.9999. Well, you get 6.9994001. So what we do is we say, well, as x gets closer to 2, it looks like my function has an output value that's getting closer and closer and closer to 7. Now, this is going in one direction. It's kind of going from 2 from underneath. For reasons that we'll see later, it turns out we want to go in both directions when we do these types of problems. So we'd also want to create another table where we start from above 2 and get closer to 2 from above. So we might want to plug in 2.5, for instance. If that were the case, again, I trust that you can plug in and type in those values. If we plug in 2.5, we get 10.25. If I plug in 2.1, I get 7.61. If I plug in 2.01, I get 7.0601. 2.001, plug that in, 7.006001. And then 2.0001, we're going to get 7.0006001. So notice that as we get closer to 2 from underneath, our outputs are starting to get closer to 7. And as we get closer to 2 from above, our outputs are also getting closer to 7. So what we would say is that as numerically, as x gets closer to 2, the outputs, or just maybe we'd say f of x, gets the output, I should say the output, f of x gets closer to 7. So that's what we do numerically. So numerically, we pick numbers that are right above the x value. We plug them into our function and we just look at the outputs. And if the outputs are getting closer to, in this case, 7 from above, and in this case, 7 from below, then we can say as x gets closer to 2, the output f of x gets closer to 7. Now, that's the numerical method for finding limits. We can also look at this graphically as well. So we can look at this on a graph. Now, we already know that the output gets closer to 7 as x gets closer to 2. But let's check out how we could have done that graphically. Now, you could, if you'd like, graph this on a graphing calculator like the TI-84 and do it that way. Or what you could do is graph this on some computer system like I'm doing here. This is desmos.com. And what I've simply done is graphed that parabola. This is the parabola y equals x squared plus 2x minus 1. So here's what's happening graphically. Remember, we're saying as x gets closer to 2, well, this horizontal axis is the x-axis. So what we're saying is As the value of x gets closer to 2, what's my function approaching? So what I like to do is I like to sort of travel along the function up until my function hits the x value of 2. So as I'm traveling along this function, as my x value is getting closer and closer to 2, my point is getting closer and closer to this point here. In particular, the point 2.7. Well, that's the same from the other direction as well. As you travel down and you get closer and closer and closer to 2 as you go down, you're getting closer and closer and closer to the point 2.7. So another way you can visualize that is through sliders. So what you can do is you can say, well, let's take a vertical line and let's let that vertical line get closer and closer and closer to the x equals 2. Well, as it's getting closer and closer to x equals 2, where that vertical line hits the graph is at the point 2.7. So we're scrolling along and we're saying, as you travel along this graph, what's the y value? And you know, you can do that with a vertical line and a horizontal line at the same time. Like, what point are we traveling along, or what point are we at as we travel along? So for instance, at 1.5, when our x value is 1.5, our y value is 4.25. And then as we go closer and closer and closer, here's our x value of 1.9. There you go, 6.41 right there. And then as we get closer and closer, eventually we're almost right on the 2.7. So we're getting closer and closer and closer to the 2.7 as we do this. Now, I don't typically like to view this in terms of, you know, sliders. What I typically like to do is I like to just travel along the curve. I like to take a point here, travel along the curve, and kind of see where it's going to as the x value gets closer to 2 from below, and then as the x value gets closer to 2 from above. All right. And they both look like they're traveling towards the point 2.7. Now, the obvious question is, why are we even doing this? Why would we ask a question that's so basic, essentially? What good does it do to me to talk about why we're traveling towards a point rather than what point are we at? I mean, it was pretty clear in that example that, you know, when you plug in an x value of 2, you get a y value of 7, both graphically and numerically. If you'd plug the x value of 2 in numerically, you get an output, which is 7. And graphically, you can see that the function crosses the point 2.7. Well, it turns out that this is a really nice function. And you're going to have to just trust me for a little bit, because we're going to see later on in the semester that not all functions are this nice. And the concept of limits are going to be really useful once we get into some other functions. And in particular, once we get into things like rates of change and approximations. So that's where things get really nice. So trust me on that. It's one of those things you'll find out later. So here's what I'd like you to do. I would like you to do these two problems, both numerically and graphically. Again, these are not the most interesting problems, but I want you to try these on your own, both numerically, graphically. Numerically, come up right out the table. Graphically, use your graphing calculator or some graphing calculator you find on the internet to graph the function, and then figure out the output as x gets closer to the given number for each of these two examples.